Revelations 2, verse 20 to 22, the Bible says, "But I have this complaint against you. You are permitting that woman, that Jezebel who called herself a prophet, to lead my servants astray. She teaches them to commit sexual sin and to eat food offered to idols. I give her time to repent, but she does not want to turn away from her immorality. Therefore, I will throw her on a bed of suffering, and those who commit adultery with her will suffer greatly unless they repent and turn away from her evil deeds." The word Jezebel came from the Old Testament story of Queen Jezebel back in the days of Elijah. She was a willing queen. Back at that time, she had killed many of God's prophets when she was in charge. The Jezebel spirit is a type of evil spirit in Satan's kingdom. There is only one devil, one Satan, but there are many spirits that will be considered a Jezebel type spirit, as they all have a particular type of personality and specific way in which they like to operate. Jezebel's spirit is one of Satan's higher ranking, more intelligent demons, if not the smartest and wicked kind of demons he has in his kingdom. The spirit of Jezebel does not care if you are a female or a male. A Jezebel spirit seeks control through manipulation and seductions. It seduces believers into idolatry and immorality. The spirit of Jezebel has been responsible for not only tearing down churches, pastors, and different Christian ministries, but it has also been responsible for breaking up many marriages, friendships, companies, along with getting many people to commit murders and suicides. Jezebel's main goal is to murder. Romans 6 verse 23 tells us, "The wages of sin is death," and Jezebel's spirit always leads people into sin. If you are doing something good for God, Jezebel will cut off your voice and destroy you. Would you recognize the Jezebel spirit if you came in contact with it? There are many signs to be aware of to find out if you are dealing with a person that has the Jezebel spirit. A person with the Jezebel spirit will refuse to admit guilt or wrongdoing, uses people to accomplish its agenda. A person with a Jezebel spirit will do everything in its power to destroy a person with prophetic ministry or gifts. A person with a Jezebel spirit will lie, even when they do not need to. When someone with a Jezebel spirit is confronted, he commonly spiritualizes the situation, blaming it on God. A person with Jezebel spirit will belittle another person in the most subtle way. The strategy is to gain control by minimizing the value of another person. A person filled with the Jezebel spirit likes to be the center of attention and does not like to see others recognized. A person with a Jezebel spirit is vengeful. A person filled with Jezebel's spirit is never wrong. If you contradict or confront one, get ready to become his worst enemy. A Jezebel's spirit is usually blatant regarding his knowledge of everything, quick to express his opinion in any area. In a marriage, if the woman is dealing with this spirit, she will try to take over her husband's authority as the head of the household and will try to totally replace him as the spiritual head of the household. If you ever come across a person who has this kind of evil spirit on them, go direct to God the Father in prayer and get his direct advice and strategy on how to deal with this spirit. If you ever notice that your destiny is delayed or you are experiencing more warfare than is normal, that is because there are words in operation in the spiritual realm that need to be broken down and destroyed. If you suffer from this evil, wicked spirit, you need to pray to break it off you. Canceling this assignment starts with forgiving anyone who has ever spoken against you, and then repent for any negative words you have spoken. To break the power of Jezebel's word over your life, you need to rebuke and renounce it. All words spoken against you, your family, your business, or your ministry. Break off all word curses, speaking aloud, "I cancel all word curses and attacks from the enemy in Jesus' name." You need to cancel all assignment of the enemy to steal, kill, and destroy your life, your health, your family, your business, your ministry, and your finances. Speak Isaiah 54 verse 17 over your life. "No weapon that is formed against me shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against me in judgment, I shall condemn." Bind the words of those who speak negative over you. Declare to bind their tongue, their mouths, their lips, and voice box from speaking negative words, gossip, slander, and anything that does not edify, exhort, or build up. Keep your tongue from evil. Your prayers are most effective when you are not in sin. You cannot break something off your life you are putting on others. Finally, declare aloud over your life, "There shall be no evil before you, neither any plague come near your tent. Psalm 91 verse 10. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the authority to battle against the controlling powers of witchcraft that attacks me in Jesus' name. I bound every negative unscriptural word spoken against my life. I break the power of confusion, torment, fear, control, and manipulation. I take captive every vain imagination and high thought that is contrary to the word of God in my life. I submit my will, my thoughts, and my life to the Lordship of Jesus Christ and plead the blood of Jesus over my mind, commanding stability in order to prevail in my soul. I break the power of witchcraft, deception, seduction, sorcery, intimidation, knowing that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow. I decree freedom from dark powers, Jezebel, false prophetic words, controller, manipulators, soothsayer, sorcerers, witches, counterfeit, soul ties, spiritual folly, lying spirits, lying dreams and visions. I repent of sins, both known and unknown, and submit myself thoroughly to the Lordship of Jesus Christ and His Word. I clothe myself with God's armor and take up the weapons of my warfare that are not carnal, but mighty in the pulling down of strongholds. I dedicate myself to the will of Jesus Christ. I repent of rebellion, pride, arrogance, spiritualism, control, manipulation, vain desires, disrespecting the fivefold ascension gifts and my leaders. I renounce wrong associations, carrying witchcraft messages, false motives, and hidden agendas. Lord, your word says, if I confess my sins, you are faithful and just to forgive me for my sins and cleanse me of all unrighteousness. I now address you, Jezebel, in the spirit realm, and I declare that I recognize that cord of occultic powers, and I destroy this cord of occultic powers in the almighty name of Jesus Christ. It is written in 2 Samuel 22, verse 32 to 37, for who is God but the Lord, and who is a rock except our God? God is my strong fortress. He guides the blameless in his way and sets him free. He makes my feet like the hinds. He sets me secure and confident upon the heights. He trains my hands for war, so that my arm can bend in bow of bronze. You have also given me the shield of salvation, and your condescensions and gentleness have made me great. You have enlarged my steps under me, so that my feet have not slipped. I now take the word of the Spirit, and I destroy their cord of compromise in the almighty name of Jesus. It is written in Acts 24 verse 14, but this I confess to you, however, that in accordance with the way which they call a sect, I worshiped God of our fathers, still persuaded of the truth of and believing in and placing full confidence in everything laid down in the laws of Moses or written in the prophets. And in Matthew 22 verse 37, and he replied to him, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. I now address you, Jezebel, in the spirit realm, and I declare that I recognize your cord of immorality and idolatry. I now take the sword of the Spirit, and I remove this cord of immorality and idolatry in the almighty name of Jesus Christ. It is written in Revelation 19 verse 7, let us rejoice and shout for joy. Let us celebrate and ascribe to him glory and honor, for the marriage of the Lamb at last has come, and his bride has prepared herself. I now address you, Jezebel, in the spirit realm, and I declare that I recognize your cord of domination, intimidation, and manipulation. I now take the sword of the Spirit, and I remove this cord of domination, intimidation, and manipulation in the almighty name of Jesus Christ. It is written in John 10, verse 2 to 5, but he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. The watchman opens the door for this man, and the sheep listen to his voice and heed it. And he calls his own sheep by name and brings them out. When he has brought his own sheep outside, he walks on before them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will never follow a stranger, but will run away from him because they do not know the voice of strangers or recognize their call. I now address you, Jezebel, in the spirit realm, and I declare that I recognize your cord of false religion. I now take the sword of the Spirit, and I remove the sword of false religion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As it is written in John 4 verse 24, God is a spirit, and those who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Father, in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, I now declare a divorce with the spirit of Jezebel. A divorce with spirit of Jezebel, a cancellation of all worship she ever received through me, my ancestors, my descendants, nullification of any and every covenant ever made with her. In the authority of the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, I now take this seed in myself and hand it over to the kingdom of God. Father, in Jesus' name, I ask that you will remove the following curses and results due to my ancestors and my own involvement with this Jezebel spirit's activities. Father, I ask that you will remove curse of bed of anguish and suffering, curse of the utmost judgment, curse of death, curse of humiliation and nakedness, curse of slavery, curse of mental confusion, curse of homosexuality and lesbianism, curse of cancer, curse of divorce, curse of male and female domination, curse of incest, curse of blasphemy, curse of loss of children, curse of loss of marriage, curse of disaster and evil, curse of loneliness and desolation, curse of witchcraft, curse of persecution. I pray that you will change each one of these curses to blessings in my ancestors, my own, and my descendants' life in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I now bind and rebuke the spirit of Jezebel for my life forever. I speak destruction over the altars where the spirit of Jezebel received worship in my life, and I erect an altar there for God Almighty. It is written in 2 Samuel 22 verse 25, David built there an altar to the Lord and offered burnt offering and peace offering. So the Lord heeded the prayers of the land, and Israel's plague was stayed. The stronghold in my life where Jezebel has lived is now destroyed, and a throne for Jesus Christ is erected there, in the mighty name of Jesus. I now speak death over all fruit of manipulations through the spirit of witchcraft in my life tonight. Father, remove all leaven that caused me to walk under the control of the spirit from my habits of thinking, my will, my emotions, and my body. Father, in Jesus' precious name, I pray that spirit of Elijah will rise up within me to expose the spirit of Jezebel in the body of Christ. I pray, Father, that the hearts of the fathers will be turned towards their children according to Malachi 4, verse 5 to 6. I pray that the disobedient will be turned towards the wisdom of the righteous, that you will enable me to outwork godly principles to handle problems in my life. I pray that more and more spiritual fathers and mothers will come forth out of our midst to show the way and to take your children by the hand and lead them unto path of righteousness. Foul spirit of Jezebel, I stand against you in Jesus' mighty name. It is written in the word of God that whatsoever I bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever I loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Therefore tonight I bound the spirit of Jezebel in the heavenlies. I bind up Jezebel with chains from heaven, and I loose God's holy warrior angels to battle on my behalf. Father, send forth your angels from heaven to help cast out this demonic spirit. There is no throne for you, Jezebel. You are no queen. You are common, and you are a liar. You are not a virgin. You are not tender and delicate. You are an ugly, wrinkled old witch. I take away and destroy all false idols and all sacrifices, destroying the sanctity of marriage. There shall be no sacrifices. I command you to take the millstones and grind the mill. Remove your veil, uncover your locks, lift up your skirt, bare your thighs and cross over the rivers. I expose your nakedness and expose your shame to the world. I come in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of hosts. I command you, Jezebel, no rest for you tonight. You are defeated in Jesus' name. The smoke rises up to heaven as with Sodom and Gomorrah. You are defeated and your men are destroyed. You shall become a widow in 1 hour. You shall suffer loss of children. The Lord says he will toss you into a bed and burn you with fire. I put the blood of Jesus all over you, for it cleanses, purifies, and sets the captives free. I take a stand to rebuke, bind, and banish to hell the spirit of Jezebel. I rebuke and cut off the harlots and mistresses of Jezebel and break their power over marriages tonight. I war against this spirit, intimidation and control to set all captives free tonight. I declare in faith that every chain and every captive that this spirit has is destroyed tonight and broken. I break and smash the power of manipulation, lies, denial, and deception caused by the spirit of Jezebel. I rebuke all spirits of false teaching and false prophecy connected to Jezebel. I pray for spouses to be delivered from pride, infatuation, seduction, lust, perversion, rebellion, selfishness, fornication, adultery, and witchcraft plotted against them by the spirit of Jezebel. I pray for husbands and wives to be delivered from sexual sins, immorality, and idolatry. I bound up the powers of the witch and seal them. I pray that the wickedness of Jezebel be revealed to the whole world tonight. I pray that all corruption, destructions, nakedness, and shame caused by Jezebel be exposed in the name of Jesus. I recognize that rebellious men and women covertly operated in the Jezebel spirit. I recognize that this spirit torments men's souls and that the battle is not with our spouse but against the spirit of Jezebel. I renounce and remove the spirit of Jezebel from the thrones of men's hearts tonight. I pray restoration for marriages in the name of my Lord Jesus Christ. I declare freedom, deliverance, healing, joy, and peace for all captives in the mighty name of Jesus. I claim this victory through the blood of the Lamb and by the word of God. I rejoice with thanksgiving to God and triumph in His glory in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus, that you said you will never leave me nor forsake me, even to the end of age. In Jesus' name, I seal this prayer by the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen.